Let us continue hybridization. In hybridization, we will take sulfur trioxide molecule. We are taking sulfur trioxide molecule in which central atom is sulfur. Central atom is sulfur. Sulfur electronic configuration is neon, 3s2, 3p4, 3d is 0. Sir, SO3 structure we will see as per valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. Sulfur we have written. Sulfur comes under group number 6a. Therefore, this valence shell is having 6 electrons. This valence shell is having 6 electrons. 3 oxygen atoms. So 1, 2, 3. 3 oxygen atoms we can write. Now, oxygen comes under 6a group. Therefore, this valence shell is having 6 electrons. Oxygen comes under 6a group. Therefore, this valence shell has 6 electrons we can write. 6 electrons. Now we can give the bonding. Here we can give double bond. Here we can give double bond. Here we can give double bond. So this is a SO3. In this SO3, the central atom sulfur is having 3 sigma bond pairs, 3 sigma bonds, and 3 pi bonds. No lone pairs. No lone pairs. Lone pairs not present in the central atom sulfur. 3 double bonds are there. Double bond in the sense generally 1 sigma, 1 pi. Therefore, 3 sigma bonds and 3 pi bonds. Lone pairs not present in the central atom of sulfur. Okay. So now, if sulfur is having 3 sigma bonds, so it has to provide 3 hybrid orbitals. Therefore, from the valence shell of sulfur, 3 orbitals undergo intermixing. One orbital is 3s. One 3s orbital. Then 2 3p orbitals. 2 3p orbitals. Okay, 2 3p orbitals undergoing intermixing. These two undergo intermixing. Then 3 pi bonds are there. For 3 pi bonds, 3 pure orbitals are required. Out of p, out of 3 orbitals of p, 2 orbitals have gone for intermixing. Remaining 1 orbital is said that. Then 3d orbital 2 times. 3d orbital 2 times in order to form pi bond. Okay. So now this one 3s orbital and 2 3p orbitals undergo intermixing. Undergo intermixing. Therefore, how many hybrid orbitals produced in the sense? 3 hybrid orbitals produced. So 3 hybrid orbitals produced. 3 hybrid orbitals produced. What is the name of hybrid orbital is sp2. So sp2 hybrid orbital is produced. Hybrid orbital means one small lobe, one big lobe. So 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals produced. 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals produced. So 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals produced. This 3p orbital is pure orbital. It is for pi bonding. This 3p orbital is for pi bonding. This 3p orbital for pi bonding. This 3d orbital. This 3d orbital is for pi bonding. Okay, another 3d orbital we will take. That 3d orbital also for pi bonding. That 3d orbital also for pi bonding. Okay, so that from the valence shell of the sulfur, one 3s orbital and 2 3p orbitals undergo intermixing to give 3 hybrid orbitals. They are sp2 hybrid orbitals. 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals. The remaining one 3p orbital will be there, that is for pi bonding, and 2 3d orbitals also for pi bonding, because 3 pi bonds are there. Okay, sir. Now, in the valence shell, 6 electrons are there in the sulfur. Sulfur valence shell, 6 electrons are there. Sulfur is having 6 bonds. Therefore, all the 6 electrons have gone for bonding. Therefore, all the 6 electrons we will distribute into these orbitals equally. Equally, we will distribute. So in this hybrid orbital, one unpaired electron. In this hybrid orbital, one unpaired electron. In this hybrid orbital, one unpaired electron. In this pure 3p orbital, one unpaired electron for pi bonding. In this pure 3d orbital, one unpaired electron for pi bonding. In this 3d orbital, one unpaired electron. Okay. 3 oxygen atoms. First oxygen atom we will take. Oxygen is a helium, 2s2, 2s2, 2p4, 2s2, 2p4. 2s2, 2p4. Okay. This is a 2p orbitals. Another oxygen atom I will take. I am taking another oxygen atom. That configuration is a helium, 2s2, 2s2 2p4 2s2 2p4, it is another oxygen atom, it is 2p orbitals. Next oxygen I will take another oxygen atom, that helium configuration is 2s2 2p4 is another oxygen atom we have written. Now we will go for bonding. Now we are going for bonding. Now see that this sp2 orbital of sulfur and this p orbital of oxygen undergo overlapping to give sigma bond. In this sigma bond, sulfur is providing sp2 orbital and this oxygen is providing p orbital. Okay, next, this sp2 orbital of sulfur and p orbital of this oxygen undergo in axial overlapping to give what bond? In the sense, sigma bond. This sigma bond is formed by overlapping of sp2 orbital of sulfur and p orbital of oxygen. Okay, next, this sp2 orbital of sulfur and this p orbital of oxygen undergo axial overlapping to give sigma bond. This sigma bond is formed by sp2 orbital of sulfur and p orbital of oxygen. Sir, now see, sulfur has provided 3 sp2 orbitals. All the 3 sp2 orbitals have bonded with oxygen atoms through sigma bond. So this sulfur with oxygen sigma bond, sulfur with oxygen sigma bond, sulfur with oxygen sigma bond. Okay, next we'll see about pi bond. We'll see this p orbital of sulfur and this p orbital of oxygen undergo pi bonding. Okay, this p orbital, pure orbital, sulfur 3p orbital, oxygen 2p orbital undergo lateral overlapping to give pi bonding. In this pi bonding, sulfur providing p orbital, oxygen is providing p orbital, therefore this pi bond is called p pi bond. Then this d orbital, this d orbital of sulfur and p orbital of oxygen undergo lateral overlapping to give pi bond. This pi bond is formed by sulfur d orbital, oxygen p orbital to give pi bond. Okay, next, this d orbital and this p orbital undergo lateral overlapping to give pi bond. This pi bond is formed by d orbital of sulfur and p orbital of oxygen to give pi bond. Okay, so this d orbital of sulfur d orbital, oxygen p orbital undergo lateral overlapping to give pi bond. This pi bond is d pi p pi bond. Okay, therefore in this SO3 three sigma bonds are there. How the three sigma bonds are there, we will see. First sigma bond, sp2p overlapping. Second sigma bond, sp2p overlapping. Third sigma bond, sp2p overlapping. So that all the three sigma bonds in the sulfur in SO3 have same nature. All the three sigma bonds have same nature, sir. Regarding pi bonds, we will see. One pi bond is called p pi bond. One pi bond is called p pi bond. Another pi bond is called d pi p pi bond. Next pi bond is called d pi p pi bond. The pi bonds present like this. Okay, so in SO3, how many p pi bonds are there? One. How many d pi p pi bonds are there? Two. Two d pi p pi bonds are present. This is about a structure of a sulfur trioxide. So here, hybridization of sulfur. In this case, hybridization of sulfur is sp2. This shape is what in the sense? Trigonal planar. Here, this shape is a trigonal planar. Bond angle is 120 degree for this. Okay, this is about SO3. Okay, next we will see about anions. We will take anions. We will take. So anions is what means carbonate. We are taking about carbonate. Carbonate formula is what in the sense CO3 2-. Carbonate formula CO3 2-. Here, this carbonate, in this carbonate, carbon is electronic configuration of carbon is helium 2s2 2p2. So 2s contains one orbital and 2p contains three orbitals. Carbon electronic configuration is helium 2s2 2p2. 2s contains one orbital, 2p contains three orbitals. We can say like this. sir. Then this carbon we will write. Carbon valence shell contains four electrons. So one electron, then second electron, third electron, fourth electron. Three oxygen atoms. One oxygen, second oxygen, third oxygen. This minus two for this minus negative charge. Minus two means negative charge. That is for oxygen, not for carbon. This minus two for which oxygen we have to give means don't give minus two for only one oxygen. Why we should not give? That we'll see. Now oxygen, its electronic configuration is 2,6. If it takes two electrons, it becomes O2 minus, then 2,8. Then noble gas configuration, neon configuration. This cannot go for a sigma bond. This oxide cannot go for a what bonding, in the sense a covalent bond or sigma bond, it cannot go. Therefore, instead, if you write O, for O, if you give one electron, you will get O minus in the sense 2,7. 7 in the sense this valence shell is having 7 electrons, it is in need of one more electron to get octet. Therefore, it can form one sigma bond or one covalent bond it can form. Therefore, this minus 2, what you have to do in the sense, give minus 1 to one oxygen and minus 1 to another oxygen, like this only you have to give. So, this minus 2, how you have to split in the sense, minus 1 to one oxygen, minus 1 to another oxygen, like this you have to split. Sir, next, we will give number of electrons. For this oxygen, the valence shell contains 6 electrons. 6 electrons you have to give. For this O minus, the valence shell contains 7 electrons we have to give. For this 7 electrons we have to give. For this O minus, we have to give 7 electrons for the valence shell. 7 electrons we have to give to the valence shell. For this O minus, we have to give 7 electrons. For this O minus, we are giving how many electrons in the sense? 7 electrons into the valence shell. Sir, now we will give here double bond, we will give. Here we will give single bond. Here we will give single bond. Okay, this will form single bond. This is also forming single bond. It is forming what in the sense? A double bond it is forming. Sir, so in the carbonate 2 minus is there. The 2 minus how we are splitting in the sense? For each oxygen, 1,1 we are giving. For each oxygen, we are giving 1,1. Sir, so carbonate we have given. In this carbon, how many sigma bonds are there? Means 3 sigma bonds are there. 3 sigma bonds and 1 pi bond is there. No lone pairs. Carbon is not having any lone pairs. This carbon is having 3 sigma bonds, 1 pi bond and no lone pairs. Sir, 3 sigma bonds in the sense, this carbon is having 3 sigma bonds. Therefore, from this carbon, 3 hybrid orbitals. This carbon has to provide 3 hybrid orbitals because it is having 3 sigma bonds. So, 3 hybrid orbitals in the sense, 3 orbitals from its valence shell should go for intermixing. So, 1 2s orbital, then 2p orbitals 2, 2p orbitals 2 undergo intermixing. 1 2p orbital is separate. 1 2p orbital is separate, that is not going for intermixing, that is needed for pi bonding. Okay, so 1 2s orbital and 2 2p orbitals undergo intermixing. Due to intermixing, how many hybrid orbitals are formed in the sense? 3 hybrid orbitals are formed. 3 hybrid orbitals are formed. What is the name of hybrid orbital in the sense? sp2. sp2 hybrid orbitals are formed. Okay. So, one sp2 hybrid orbital will write one lobe big, one lobe small. It is one sp2 hybrid orbital. Another sp2 hybrid orbital, one lobe big, one lobe small. It is another sp2 hybrid orbital. Next hybrid orbital, one lobe big, one lobe small, that is next hybrid orbital. 1 2p orbital is pure, that is not going for intermixing, that is not going for hybridization, that is needed for a pi bonding. Okay, so like this we are doing. This carbon is having 4 bonds here, valence shell is having 4 electrons, that means all the valence electrons should be unpaired. So valence shell contains 4 electrons, that 4 electrons we will distribute into these orbitals equally. Here one unpaired electron, this is for sigma bond. Here one unpaired electron, here one unpaired electron, here one unpaired electron, it is for pi bonding. So 4 unpaired electrons we have given. Next we will take oxygen, we will take. Okay, now oxygen electronic configuration is what means? Helium 2s2, helium 2s2, 2p 4. helium 2s2 2p4. This is one oxygen. Then O minus we will take O minus in the sense helium 2s2 2p5. 2s2 2p5. 2p5. This contains one unpaired electron. 2p5 contains one unpaired electron. Then O minus. This configuration is helium 2s2 2s2 2p5. Helium 2s2 2p5. It is containing one unpaired electron. This O minus contains one unpaired electron. Okay. So now we will see the bonding. We'll see. Now this sp2 orbital of carbon and this p orbital of O minus, p orbital of O minus give sigma bonding. So sigma bonding. So carbon sp2 orbital, O minus p orbital undergo axial overlapping to give sigma bond. Then carbon sp2 orbital, O minus p orbital undergo axial overlapping to give sigma bond. This sigma bond is formed by sp2 orbital of carbon and p orbital of O minus. Then this sp2 orbital of carbon, this p orbital of oxygen undergo axial overlapping to give sigma bond. This sigma bond is formed by sp2 orbital of carbon and p orbital of this oxygen. Then this 2p orbital of carbon and 2p orbital of this oxygen undergo lateral overlapping to give pi bond. This pi bond is formed by p orbital of carbon and p orbital of oxygen. Therefore, this pi bond is called a p pi bond. Now, here hybridization of carbon is sp2. Hybridization of carbon is sp2. Therefore, the shape is a trigonal planar. The shape is what in the sense? A trigonal planar for this carbonate. Okay. Next, we will take a sulfite. SO32- sulfite. Next we are taking what in the sense? Sulfite formula is what in the sense? SO32-. Now we will take sulfur. Its electronic configuration is what means? Neon 3s2 3p4 3d0. 3s2 3p4 3d0. Okay. So SO32- will write sulfur. This valency shell is having 6 electrons. That 6 electrons will write 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 electrons. Why? Because it is coming under 6th group. Therefore, 3 oxygen atoms are there. 1 oxygen atom, 2nd oxygen atom, 3rd oxygen atom. Then we will give a minus 2 is there. That minus 2 will split into, for this oxygen 1 minus 1, for this oxygen 1 minus 1. This oxygen comes under 6th group. Therefore, this valency shell contains 6 electrons. This is O minus. O minus means this valency shell. To this valency shell, we have to give 7 electrons. To this, we are giving 7 electrons. It is O minus means to this, you give 7 electrons, we have to give. Cell. Then we will give bonding. We will give here we will give double bond. Here we will give single bond. Here we will give single bond. Okay. This is what in the sense lone pair. It is a lone pair. Okay. This is called a sulfite. In this sulfite, sulfur valency shell is having one lone pair and three sigma bonds, one pi bond is there. So sulfur is having one lone pair and three sigma bonds. This is totally 4 lone pair and sigma bonds means totally 4. So sulfur has to provide 4 hybrid orbitals. Therefore, from sulfur, four orbitals from its valency shell should go for intermixing. So one is 3s orbital. One is 3s orbital and 3p orbitals. 3p orbitals. 3p orbitals. They are going for intermixing and giving how many hybrid orbitals in the sense? 4. So 4 hybrid orbitals we are getting. 4 hybrid orbitals we are getting. Okay. So one hybrid orbital will write one small lobe, one big lobe. One small lobe and one big lobe. So 4 hybrid orbitals we'll write. This 4 hybrid orbitals we have given for what sake means 1 for lone pair and 3 for sigma bonds. Now one pi bond has to be formed. So for forming one pi bond, sulfur is providing one 3D orbital. Sulfur is providing one 3D orbital because p orbitals all have gone for intermixing. Therefore, it is a 3D orbital. These are what means sp3 orbitals. These are sp3 hybrid orbitals. Okay. Then sulfur valence shell is having 6 electrons. Out of 6, 2 electrons act as lone pair. 2 electrons act as lone pair. Therefore, here we will give 1 electron pair. We will give this will act as lone pair. For remaining orbitals, 1 electron each we will give. 1 electron each. Now totally if we see 6 electrons. So valence shell contains 6 electrons. In that, this is what in the sense lone pair. This is what in the sense lone pair. Okay. Now 3 oxygens we will take. Now 3 oxygens. Oxygen electronic configuration is what means helium. 2s2, 2p4. 2s2, 2p4. So we have written 2s2, 2p4. Then 2 O- is there. O- configuration is what means helium. 2s2, 2p5. 2s2, 2p5. 2s2, 2p5. Another O- we will write. That configuration is what means helium. 2s2, 2p5. 2s2, 2p5. Okay, 2s2, 2p5 we have written. Now we will write bonding. We will give this is lone pair. This sp3 of sulfur and this oxygen of this 2p orbital of oxygen undergo sigma bonding. So in this sigma bond, sulfur provides sp3, oxygen provides p orbital. Next, this sp3 of sulfur and this p orbital of O minus give sigma bond. So sulfur sp3 O minus p orbital. Then this sp3 orbital and this p orbital of O minus give sigma bond. So sulfur sp3 oxygen p orbital. Then this 3d orbital, this p orbital of oxygen go for lateral overlapping to give pi bond. In this pi bond formation, sulfur provides a d orbital, oxygen provides p orbital. Therefore this pi bond is d pi p pi bond. This pi bond is a d pi p pi bond, we can say. So sulfur, for this sulfur, what is hybridization in the sense? sp3 hybridization. sp3 hybridization having one lone pair. One lone pair and 3 sigma bonds in the sense, it is pyramidal shape or trigonal pyramidal shape. Trigonal pyramid. Trigonal pyramid, otherwise simply pyramidal shape we can say. It is for sulfite. Next we'll take SO4 2-. SO4 2- is sulfate. SO4 2- is sulfate. Central atom sulfur. Sulfur electronic configuration is neon. Neon. 3s2, 3p, 3p4, 3d0. Neon. 3s2, 3p4, 3d0 we can say. Okay. So sulfur electronic configuration is neon. 3s2, 3p4, 3d0. Sir, SO4 2- we'll see sulfur. This valence shell is having 6 electrons, 2 electrons, 4 electrons, 5th electron, 6th electron. Okay. And 4 oxygen atoms. 1 oxygen, 2nd oxygen, 3rd oxygen, 4th oxygen. Then -2. -2 you distribute as a -1, -1, 2 oxygens. -1 for this oxygen, -1 for this oxygen. This oxygen valence shell is having 6 electrons. This oxygen valence shell is having 6 electrons. This oxygen valence shell is having 6 electrons. This O minus valence shell has 7 electrons. This O minus valence shell has 7 electrons. This O minus also valence shell is having 7 electrons. Now we will give bonding. We will give here we can give double bond. Here we can give double bond. Here we can give single bond. Here we can give single bond. Okay. Now this sulfur valence shell is having 4 sigma bonds and 2 pi bonds. This sulfur valence shell is having 4 sigma bonds and 2 pi bonds. So 4 sigma bonds means 4 hybrid orbitals are required. So from this sulfur, 4 atomic orbitals undergo intermixing. So 1 3s orbital, 1 3s orbital and 3 3p orbitals. 3 3p orbitals. 3 3p orbitals undergo intermixing. Undergo intermixing and gives how many hybrid orbitals in the sense 4 hybrid orbitals. 4 hybrid orbitals. So we are getting 4 hybrid orbitals. One hybrid orbital is this. This name is sp3. Another hybrid orbital is this. This name is sp3. Another hybrid orbital sp3. Next hybrid orbital sp3. So two pi bonds. For forming two pi bonds, it has to provide two pure orbitals. From 3p, it cannot provide. All the three 3p orbitals have gone for intermixing, so it has to provide from 3d. So from 3d, it is providing. So one 3d orbital, another 3d orbital for a pi bonding. So in this sulfur, six bonds are there. That valence shell is having six electrons. So all the six electrons have gone for bonding. There is no lone pair here. So that you give the six electrons in the valence shell, six electrons of valence shell, you give one electron to each these orbitals. One electron each we have given. Okay. Sorry. Now, how the oxygen is making bond, that we will see. Oxygen is making bond for one oxygen atom, configuration is helium, 2s2, 2p4, 2s2, 2p4. 2s2, 2p4 we have written. Sorry. Another oxygen atom we will take. For another oxygen atom, configuration is helium, 2s2, 2s2, 2p4. 2s2, 2p4. Then 2 times O minus, 1 O minus, configuration is helium, 2s2, 2p5. O minus means 2p5. O minus means 2p5. Another O minus, helium, 2s2, 2p5. 2s2, 2p5. Okay, now we will go for bonding. This sulfur sp3 and oxygen p orbital. Oxygen p orbital go for sigma bonding. Sulfur sp3, oxygen p orbital. Okay, then sulfur sp3, oxygen p orbital. Oxygen p orbital go for sigma bonding. Sulfur sp3, oxygen p orbital go for sigma bonding. Sulfur sp3, oxygen p orbital go for sigma bonding. So sulfur sp3, oxygen p orbital. Sulfur sp3, oxygen p orbital go for sigma bonding. So sp3p. Sulfur 3d. Oxygen 2p go for pi bonding. In this pi bond formation, sulfur provides a d orbital, oxygen provides p orbital. Therefore, this pi bond is d pi p pi bond. This 3d and this oxygen 2p go for pi bonding. In this pi bond formation, sulfur provides a d orbital, oxygen provides p orbital. Therefore, this pi bond is a d pi p pi bond. Okay. So in this sulfate, sulfur is the central atom. Sulfur undergoes sp3 hybridization. Therefore, it is a tetrahedral shape. This sulfate is coming under what category in the sense? Tetrahedral. Then we'll take ClO4-. ClO4- is called a perchlorate. ClO4- is called perchlorate. Central atom is chlorine. Chlorine electronic configuration is neon, 3s2, 3p5, 3d is 0. It is a configuration of the chlorine electronic configuration. Now we will take perchlorate. Chlorine valence shell contains 7 electrons because it is coming under 7th A group. This is coming under 7th A group. Then 4 oxygens, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then minus charge is there, net charge is minus 1 is there, that you give to one oxygen, you give. For this oxygen is having minus 1 charge, therefore this valence shell has 7 electrons. Minus 1 means 7 electrons we have to say. Now, this oxygen valence shell has 6 electrons. This oxygen valence shell has 6 electrons. It is also 6 electrons because it is coming under 6th A group. This oxygen coming under 6th A group because this valence shell is having 6 electrons. Here we can give double bond, we can give. Here also we can give double bond. Here we are giving double bond. Here we are giving single bond. Okay. Now, this chlorine is having 4 sigma bonds. This chlorine is having 4 sigma bonds and 3 pi bonds. This chlorine is having 4 sigma bonds and 3 pi bonds. Okay. Now this chlorine is having 4 sigma bonds. So this chlorine is providing 4 hybrid orbitals. So 4 hybrid orbitals means from the valence shell of chlorine, 4 orbitals should go for intermixing. So one orbital is 3s. One orbital is 3s and 3 3p orbitals. 3 3p orbitals. These orbitals are going for intermixing. Therefore, we are getting 4 hybrid orbitals. We are getting how many hybrid orbitals? In the sense, 4 hybrid orbitals. One hybrid orbital we have written. Second hybrid orbital. Third hybrid orbital. Fourth hybrid orbital. So these 4 hybrid orbitals are needed for forming what bonding? In the sense, sigma bonding for Cl. Then Cl is having 3 pi bonds. In order to form 3 pi bonds, Cl is providing 3 pure orbitals. It can't give from p because all the p orbitals have gone for hybridization. So it can give only 3d. It can give, that's all. So it is providing 3 3d orbitals for pi bonding. 3 3d orbitals it is providing for pi bonding. Okay. So chlorine is having 7 bonds here, and valence shell is having 7 electrons. Therefore, all the 7 electrons have gone for bonding. Therefore, you give 1 electron each to these orbitals. 1 electron each you give. This orbital is what means sp3. This hybrid orbital's name is what means sp3. Okay. Then oxygen we'll see. Oxygen electronic configuration is what means helium 2s2, helium 2s2, 2p4. Helium 2s2, 2p4 we can say. So 2p5 we can say O minus means. O minus means 2p5 we have to say. So oxygen electronic configuration is helium 2s2, 2p4. 2s2, 2p4 we are saying. Okay. Helium 2s2, 2p4. So another oxygen atom, that configuration is what means helium 2s2, 2p4. Helium 2s2, 2p4. So another oxygen atom, helium 2s2, 2p4. 2s2, 2p4. Okay. So like this we have written. So now we will give bonding. We will give now this sp3 of chlorine, this O minus of this p orbital, O minus of this p orbital go for sigma bonding. In the sigma bond formation, sp3 of chlorine and p orbital of O minus, p orbital of O minus form this sigma bond. Then this sp3, chlorine sp3, oxygen p orbital form sigma bond. This sigma bond is formed by chlorine sp3, oxygen p orbital. Then this sp3 and oxygen p orbital go for sigma bond, chlorine sp3 orbital, oxygen p orbital. Next step, this sp3 orbital, okay, this sp3 orbital and oxygen p orbital go for sigma bonding. So chlorine sp3 orbital, oxygen p orbital forming sigma bond. Okay, next we'll see pi bond. This 3d orbital, this p orbital forming pi bond. This pi bond is formed by chlorine d orbital and oxygen p orbital. Okay, next step, this 3d orbital, this p orbital, okay, forming pi bond. So in this pi bond formation, chlorine d orbital, oxygen p orbital forming pi bond. Next step, this 3d and this p, so it is forming pi bond. This pi bond is formed by chlorine d orbital, oxygen p orbital. Okay, therefore in this perchlorate, chlorine is having 3 pi bonds. All the 3 pi bonds have same nature, d pi p pi nature. Okay, and all the sigma bonds have same nature, sp3p. okay, so here chlorine central atom is undergoing hybridization sp3. Therefore it is what in the sense, tetrahedral shape. Okay, next we will take a chlorate, ClO3 minus. ClO3 minus is what means chlorate. Central atom is Cl, 3 oxygen atoms we will write. Chlorine valence shell contains 7 electrons because it is coming under 7th group. Sir, 7 electrons we are written. Oxygen, for 1 oxygen we have to give -1, this -1. Oxygen valence shell contains 7 electrons. The because O minus. This oxygen valence shell contains 6 electrons. here we can give double bond, we can give here, we can give double bond here, we can give single bond. Okay, so now this chlorine is having one lone pair and three sigma bonds and two pi bonds. So one lone pair and three sigma bonds means totally four in the sense sp3 hybridization. Okay, totally four in the sense sp3 hybridization, one for s, three for p, therefore sp3 hybridization. And here two pi bonds are there. Now see, all the p orbitals have gone for hybridization, therefore chlorine can give only d orbital for pi bonding. Chlorine will give d orbital, oxygen will give p orbital, therefore the two pi bonds are what means d pi p pi. Okay, then we will take chlorite. Chlorite is ClO2 minus. So Cl we have written, two oxygens we have written, for one oxygen minus one we have written. For chlorine valence shell, for chlorine we have to give 7 electrons in the valence shell. For chlorine we have given 7 electrons in the valence shell. For this oxygen valence shell, 6 electrons we are giving. For O minus valence shell, we are giving 7 electrons we are giving. For O minus we are giving 7 electrons. Here sigma bond, here what means double bond. Okay, now this Cl is having how many sigma bonds in the sense? 2 sigma bonds, 2 lone pairs. Then 1 pi bond is there. Okay, now 2 sigma bonds plus 2 lone pairs means 4 electron pairs. That 4 electron pairs means sp3 hybridization. 1 for s, 3 for p. sp3 hybridization, totally 4. This 4 divide. 1 you give for s, remaining 3 you give for p. Okay, sp3 hybridization. Now this pi bond, for the formation of pi bond, Cl can provide a d orbital. Why? Because all the three p orbitals it has given for intermixing. Therefore, it can give only d orbital. Therefore, d pi p pi bond. Oxygen can give p orbital. So pi bond is a d pi p pi bond, we can say. Next, we'll take hypochlorite. Next, we are taking hypochlorite. Hypochlorite formula is ClO minus. ClO minus. ClO minus, we can write like this. Chlorine valence shell 7 electrons because it is coming under 7th group. O minus valence shell 7 electrons. O minus valence shell 7 electrons. Here only one bond. Therefore, hybridization is not required. Okay, sir. We said like this. Sir, so far we have discussed about hybridization. In the hybridization, hybrid orbitals explaining sigma bond formation and lone pair occupation. Hybrid orbitals is not explaining pi bond formation. Why does hybrid orbital do not explain pi bond formation? Hybrid orbitals do not explain pi bond formation. Why is it so? Whereas pure orbitals explaining pi bond formation. Suppose if you take, now I will take this is one p orbital. This is one p orbital. These two p orbitals can go for lateral overlapping to give pi bond. That pi bond we can give like this. This is called a lateral overlapping. This lateral overlapping result pi bond. So p orbitals undergo lateral overlapping and give pi bonding. Sir, what about d orbitals? Can d orbitals give pi bonding or not? We'll see. Now we'll take one d orbital and one p orbital. We'll take one p orbital. Here pi bonding formation is not possible or not possible. We'll see. This is a one d orbital. This is a one p orbital. Okay, so lateral overlapping is there. Therefore, pi bonding is possible, sir. Now, so p orbitals can give pi bonding. Between d and p orbitals can give pi bonding. Now we will take one.